going on YouTube? Quick 10 gallon update. As I was saying, I did get a blue ram for this tank. I'll try to find them. I'll get closer to the tank, but Rotala exploding, pennywort exploding as usual in this tank. The baby tears doing awesome over here. Look at this shit. It is carpeting that corner perfectly. Look at this deadly tree. Look at this shit. That is what I call awesome. That is awesome. And let me tell you guys, I tied down this piece of pennywort right here to the tree, and it is doing awesome. Yeah, I could try to zoom in on the, there's the piece of fishing wire, whatever, the fishing line. It's not the thinnest of all. It's a 6 pound weight, it's a pretty skinny line. It's not the skinniest though, so you can still see it, but it's fine. I was using it for lake fishing in Oregon, so we were catching bigger fish, so the line is a little bigger, but it's fine. But the effect is awesome. It's growing along the tree, coming outwards. It is awesome. Indeed, indeed. So there's my blue ram. He's loving the tank, I think. He's exploring everything. The colors haven't colored up perfectly because he was a little stressed out yesterday when I put him in. But, or whenever I put him in, I forgot, honestly. It was like a day or two ago. But his colors are coming back slowly. So it turns out because one of my other hatch fish has disappeared randomly. I checked all over. He's not on the floor. But anyway, I checked the tank as well. Maybe he was eaten. I have no idea. But now he's schooling with the rasboros because he's the only one left. My shrimp are doing awesome in these tanks. They keep molting. One of them's molted at least twice, I think. Or maybe they've all just molted. But, pretty sure one of them has been molting consistently. Yeah, these guys are awesome. I'm gonna see if I can get a couple more of them. Put a couple of couple more in the 38 and more in this 10 gallon. But yeah, look at them go with the hatchet fish. Schooling with them now. When the hatchet moves, so does everyone else. When the reservoirs move, so does the hatchet. My remaining auto doing awesome. I'm trying to get a clear shot of the ram. He doesn't seem to want to come out really right now. He was out swimming earlier. But, yeah, so I ordered the same filter as this one, the Tom's 80 gallon per hour mini canister, because this filter's just not doing it. Really not doing it for me. I've noticed a huge difference. The instant I switch from the Azu to the canister on this tank, algae is lowered, surface agitation's good. It just seems to be cleaning the water way better. I'm fighting some severe algae issues. It's hard when you're working long hours during the day and then you get home, you're tired, you do some maintenance, but can't do as much as you want, but I'm gonna fix this tank up, see what I can do. The filter should arrive sometime this week, so that should hopefully help. I mean, things are growing great in this tank, but the algae is also growing great, so that's a problem. And my fluval edge, changed it up, took out that piece of driftwood that was there. Wasn't feeling it, put a little Rotala in there, like the baby ones. So hopefully that'll grow out. Crip's doing awesome. Both Crips. I took out the Anubias. It was ugly as hell in this tank. I'm gonna get some more Anubias nanas. My tetras are doing awesome. My one remaining orange shrimp is also doing awesome. You can see the orange right there. That would be him. But took out the hair grass. Wasn't feeling it. Looked ugly as hell. And put some glosso in. A couple things of glosso. I'm gonna see how fast this thing carpets. It's still enclosed by a plastic plastic. So I don't want it spreading. I just want it to carpet in this area. I think it would look cool. But yeah, other than that, that's the tank. That is the tank. And that is my tank update. Oh, I didn't really do an update on this. I kind of passed right by it. 5.5. Planted shrimp tank. The water's finally settled down, like I was saying, because of the canister filter. Water's crystal clear. Algae's dying down. Dwarf baby tears rooting itself nicely, real nice. All the dead leaves melted away and new ones are coming in. It's carpeting already over here. You can see some of this baby shrimp I got going on. Let's see if I can focus on him. Focus, there we go. There's more back there. Another one on the Rotala, or no, not Kambamba over there, back there. And then this one up here, the big boy, or actually that's the female. There's another female back here somewhere, the big female, I don't know where she is, but yeah, fed them yesterday. I meant to do a video. They're all feasting. I put the pellet here to see if they all gathered here. All my shrimp just gathered in this area. It was awesome to watch. One of my autos passed away. I put him in a little too early, I think. The water was not as settled. But this auto is doing great. Loving the tank. Tons of things for him to eat. So yeah, that's about it. Oh, there's the ram. There is the ram. Focus. Focus. Let me see what I can do here, boys. Nope. Whoa. Damn it. Damn. Well, anyway, I'll try to get a better video someday. You can see his colors. Actually, they're shining nicely. This is too difficult. But anyway, that's the tank. I'll leave the last couple seconds. Just a video of the 10-gallon. Let you guys enjoy. This is my favorite tank, I think. The 38 is close. This and the 38 has to be my favorite tanks. It's just a little unfair with the driftwood in this one. It really makes it just kills the game with this piece of driftwood and the pennywort. But yeah, anyway, thanks for watching, guys. Peace!